Hi, this is Mike Roussos from the .NET Customer Success team. I'm going to talk today briefly about logging in ASP.NET Core. So if you have an ASP.NET Core app, you want to log some diagnostics, you're typically going to be using the Microsoft Extensions Logging package. So let me hop over to NuGet and show that to you. Microsoft Extensions Logging is what you're looking for. Now, you won't have to install this typically because it's already included in the package references for all of our ASP.NET Core templates. But this is the package that you use. And like all Microsoft Extensions packages, there's nothing in here specific to ASP.NET Core. This just depends on Net Standard 1.1, so you could just as easily use this logging framework in a .NET Core console app, .NET Framework app, UWP, just the same as you would in ASP.NET Core. But coming back to how it works in ASP.NET Core, when you look at your ASP.NET Core app, you'll notice that in the templates, our configure method in startup CS will take an iLogger factory. So this logger factory is what produces logger objects, which we use to log events. In the configure method, though, we need to set it up with all of the providers we want to use for writing those logged messages to different endpoints. Now, one of the great things about the Microsoft Extensions logging framework used in ASP.NET Core is its flexibility and its extensibility. By default, you'll have an add debug, which adds a debug provider so that we write to debug output. And you typically also have an add console as well in your template that you start with. And this will just write diagnostic messages out to the console output, of course. But when you look at these are extension methods, add console, add debug, and they're just extension methods that wrap iLoggerFactory.addProvider, which adds an iLogger provider. So you could very easily go out and write your own iLogger provider for any endpoint you want, although you probably don't need to because someone else already has, most likely. And I'll show you some of the many options here later in this video. But in your configure method, you add the providers, the logging syncs, that you're going to be using. Now, you'll notice that typically we'll say, you know, if it's not development, we'll do one set of things, which would not be this. And then if it's is a development environment, then maybe we'll hook up some more, which I'll talk about in a minute. But you want to do this sort of per environment configuration of your logging providers because logging can have a performance hit. Some logging providers, like ETW log providers, are fairly fast, especially if you're only logging high priority messages. But pretty much any console log provider is going to slow things down. Some others that don't batch can be slow. So you want to be cautious with how much logging you do in production. You want to kind of keep it to just the minimum batching providers which don't write out to the console. But anyhow, you come in here, you hook these up, and typically there's some sort of configuration you have to do. There's not with the debug provider because it just writes the debug output. But like when we add console, you can choose some options like what the minimum level of messages you'd like to log, or whether or not to include scopes. And scopes are the path of sort of where you are in your app. So you can push scopes and say, okay, now we're in this type or this method. And ASP.NET Core will use this to indicate which API is serving your request, for example. But most commonly, you'll just use something from configuration because most providers, like the console provider, can be set up using configuration. So we can go over in our app settings.json. If you just look at this top section now, you can see here's our configuration for how we want our console logger to work. We have log levels depending on the source of the message and whether or not to include scopes. And it's a best practice to do the configuration in a config file like an app settings.json because that way you can change your logging configuration without recompiling your app. So we've add debug, add console. Now, like I was saying, one of the great things about Microsoft Extensions logging is how many options there are for where you want to write things. If we take a look at the documentation, and I should mention, actually, where is it? Here we go. While I'm on the topic of documentation, the documentation we have for ASP.NET Core logging is quite good. So if you go out to docs.microsoft.com, look at ASP.NET Core, find the logging article. It'll have all the information from this video plus some more details, so I'd encourage you to go check that out. But if we go down to built-in logging providers, you can see that out of the box, ASP.NET Core has providers for console logging, debug logging, event source, event log, trace source, and even Azure App Service, which is pretty cool. Azure App Service logging, if we hook that up, I have a blog post that talks more about this. So I'd encourage you to go check this out as well. And I'll put the link to this blog post down in the comments below this video. But you can hook up Add Azure Web App Diagnostics. It's another add provider extension method. Optionally, you provide some settings about what format you'd like the messages in, but this is not required. And then when you deploy your application as an Azure App Service, we'll automatically start collecting those logs if logging is enabled for your app service. And you can enable it through either the portal in the diagnostics logs blade or just using the Azure CLI. Once logging is enabled for your app service, if this provider is registered, then whenever a logger generated by this iLogger factory writes a message, it'll be streamed to the application logs, which you can see either in the portal or, again, using the CLI. And like I said, I'll include a link to this blog so you can read more of these details. But if you're deploying into Azure App Service, this is a nice provider to know about. Another provider that's nice, though, like I said, it's not just our first-party ones. There's a lot of third-party providers because of the extensible nature of Microsoft Extensions logging. And Serialog is a big one because Serialog has so many syncs you can use. If you go look on their GitHub page, github.com/Serialog, here's a list of their available Serialog syncs. These are all the places that Serialog can write. So you've got everywhere from SQL Server to Azure Table Storage to AWS CloudWatch to Elasticsearch. And so really about any place you want to write logging messages from your ASP.NET Core app, you can do it either with a built-in provider or through the Serialog provider. If we come back over to my demo here, you can see I'm actually setting up a Serialog provider here by creating a new logger configuration, which is the Serialog configuration object. And then, as with most providers, you can configure Serialog either programmatically by calling .write_to and then the sync you want to use. Like here I'm saying I'm going to use Azure Table Storage. If I wanted to use Amazon CloudWatch, it's similarly simple to do programmatically. Or you can do it through configuration. So I can say .read from configuration and I pass my configuration object. So if we go back to appsettings.json, you can see down here is our Serialog configuration. By default, Serialog will look for a configuration section called Serialog, and it gets minimum level to log. It also has a write_to section where I can list the syncs that I plan to use. So in here, I'm using the literate console sync. Literate console is a very cool sync. It's a console sync, but it writes to the console, but it uses structured logging. So the idea of structured logging is worth explaining a little bit because it's really powerful. Structured logging means that when we log a message, in addition to just logging the message itself, pieces of data from within the message will be logged separately in a strongly typed way so that they can be easily queried later. Let me show you an example of how this might look. So here in my customer's controller, I have a logger, and I call log information. This is how you might log a piece of information using a Microsoft Extensions logging framework. I then provide the message that's going to be logged. But notice that I have these parameters in curly braces here. I have the HTTP verb, the method, like get, post, whatever, that was used. And then I also have a custom message that I'm just getting out of resources here for that explains the path that the request went to. And then over here we have parameters which will fill in to format this string. But because these are named curly brace parameters, Serialog recognizes these as interesting pieces of data. So when Serialog logs our message, it'll log the formatted string, which is human readable, but it will also log, if the sync supports it, these pieces of data in a standalone way. So you'll have a method name of, you know, post or get or whatever. So then, let's say I log this to Elasticsearch, which of course would support all of those structured pieces of data. I could then search through all of my logging events, all my diagnostics, for instances where method name is equal to post or put. And so it makes it really easy to query on interesting data in your logging messages without having everything just be a string that you have to parse through. So as much as possible, when you're using Microsoft Extensions logging, I encourage you to really make use of this structured logging feature because it's very powerful. And all it requires is that you're careful about the way you set up your messages so that interesting pieces of data are called out with curly braces that will be stored separately. Now, to show how we're using this in here, you'll notice that I'm just getting an iLogger in through our constructor. So all of the logging in infrastructure is provided through dependency injection in ASP.NET Core. Now, if you look in my startup CS, you'll notice we actually don't even register anything in configure services. There's a lot of stuff being registered here, but nothing related to logging. The reason for that is because ASP.NET Core will automatically provide logging services as part of its base functionality. So in configure, we can request the iLogger factory that will automatically be injected via dependency injection. Similarly, then, after we've configured it in our controllers, we can request an iLogger, and that will be provided. Now, you notice that the iLogger is generic. What we pass here is going to be the category. So typically, you're going to pass the class, which is doing the logging, because this will be the category which log messages are categorized into. So it's a nice way of keeping separate things that come from one controller versus another controller. So that's why within the customer's controller, I get an iLogger of customer's controller. Now, you can create iLoggers explicitly, and if you do that, you can request whatever category you want, but this is a nice just sort of a nice standard way of doing it. You can actually see here in this sample, I have some custom middleware that's just defined right in line. It doesn't have its own class. So to create a logger to use in there, I just call loggerfactory.createLogger, and then I specify the category that I want. And so here's another way of doing this. Then in here, in this middleware, whenever I log, this string is what will be used as the category. And again in here, you can see I'm calling log information just the same as we did before. Now, one other thing to point out also is that in appsettings.json, you can see I'm actually referring to some other some other parameters which I didn't define, like request ID and level. These things are automatically provided by ASP.NET Core as well. If you look at the blog post I was referring to earlier, you can see down here where I send some information to Elasticsearch, it gets all of those parameters. So you can see that ASP.NET Core out of the box is going to include parameters for request path, which is going to be the path the request went to, request ID, which is unique ID for correlating different events that happened while processing a single HTTP request. Action name, action ID, task ID, source context. These are all things, timestamp, which are included by default either by Microsoft Extensions Logging or ASP.NET Core. And so you can refer to these when you're creating a template path that you'd like your provider, like the console provider or the serial log, one of the serial log syncs, to use. So these can then be included in your messages. So I've gone through that really quickly. To wrap up, let me go ahead and just kick this app off, and we'll see some logging happening since I've configured the literate console. We'll just see it right in our console output. This is just a very simple web API. The app itself is not super interesting. But you can see here all of that logging happening, and you can see that the output template is being used to format the messages. So I'm getting things like the request ID, if it exists, the level, the timestamp. And then over here, if I go ahead and call the get method that we were looking at previously, you can see here that we, let's see, here it is. Here is that message that I was showing that's using structured logging. So get and getting customers are actually highlighted in cyan here by the literate console sync because it recognizes those as being string parameters that are part of the structured message. So when this goes to something like table storage or Elasticsearch, these will be called out as separate string parameters that we could query on. In the literate console, what it does is just sort of color code them to make it easy to spot things that are maybe particularly interesting or that are especially relevant to what we're looking at. And so you also can see here some of the information from that custom middleware about how long things took. And that's not even really necessary since ASP.NET Core also logs similar messages, but I included it here just as a way to demonstrate some middleware in a separate sample. But this is what the literate console output looks like. Again, this is a serial log sync because I've plugged serial log into Microsoft Extensions Logging through their provider. And in general, this is just a super flexible way of logging in your ASP.NET Core apps. I hope this has been helpful. Thanks.